Welcome to day number 2, topic, grasping the gift. And the passage for consideration, Ephesians chapter 3, verse 18. This is what the Word of God says in the New International Version. How wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. How can we experience the fullness of God's love? We read what the Apostle Paul says in Ephesians chapter 3, 14 through to 21, and you can do that in your own time. But first, we need to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Verse 16 says, I pray that out of his glorious riches he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being. Secondly, we surrender our lives to Christ and live in a close, continual relationship with him, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. That's verse 17. And then verse 17 also says, then our faith grows and matures through Christ and the Holy Spirit in us, because we are rooted and established in love. The result? We experience the fullness of God's love. He gives us the power, together with all the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. You see, God's love passes every test. Consider the parable of the prodigal son in Luke chapter 15, 11 to 32. One day the younger son went to his father, who symbolizes God, and declared that he wanted to leave home and live his own life. Evidently, his father's household rules, the commandments, didn't suit him. The son demanded his inheritance, which he wasn't even entitled to at that time. So the father gave him his portion. The father gave him complete freedom because he loved him and respected his choice, just as God does with us. Then the son journeyed to a faraway place and proceeded to spend his money on wild parties and loose women. As the money dwindled, his circle of friends became smaller, and eventually he had nothing left. To make matters worse, a famine hit the region where he lived. So desperate to survive, he looked for work, but the only position he found was working as a swineherd. Hunger tormented him, but he wasn't even allowed to eat the pig feed. As often happens during hardships, he began to consider his life. He realized all of his father's workmen had enough to eat while he was starving, so he vowed to return to his father and say, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. The son started home with mixed feelings, but his father was already watching for him. Full of compassion, the father ran forward, fell on his son's neck, and kissed him, even though the son must have been dirty and smelly. Before the son could finish his whole confession, the father called servants to bring the best clothes and prepare a feast. Clearly, he loved his son just as before. In this story, we hear the full story of salvation, repentance and confession of the sinner, the father who waits longingly, and the joyous welcome when we return. God loves us unconditionally, but we need to go to him, just as the son went back to his father. The love of God passes every test. He will not fail to welcome you. You see, only when the son returned could the father pour out all his love. Only then was the son open to receiving all that his father wanted to offer. At last, nothing stood in the way of their intimate relationship, and the son could experience the complete goodness of his father, who had never stopped waiting. Let's go back to the question. How can we experience the complete fullness of God's love? By living in full daily surrender to Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. And when God's love fills our lives, we become channels of His love to others. The more we give, the more we receive. In Testimonies for the Church, Volume 8, page 191, Ellen White says, "You need a daily baptism of the love that in the days of the apostles made them all of one accord." And why is it so important to understand this divine love? Paul saw that the character of Christ must be understood before men could love Him or view the cross with the eye of faith. Here must begin that study, which shall be the science and the song of the redeemed through all eternity. What a joy to study the matchless, many-faceted love of our Savior. Won't you choose today? Turn your eyes upon Jesus.
Heavenly Father, and our great God who art in heaven, we thank you for the blessings that you have given unto us. At this moment, Lord, we thank you for the prophecy in the form of the writing of Ellen G. White. We pray for the latter rain of the Holy Spirit, for the finishing of God's work, for the climax of history in the second coming of Christ. We pray for the countries that are heavily affected by COVID-19. We pray for those suffering from COVID-19 in our local community. We pray for the distribution of the vaccine and other treatments that can help cure COVID-19. We pray for the decision maker in the local government and health department to have wisdom in their decision making. We pray for those who are financially affected by the lockdown and the job losses. We pray for the individual struggling with mental health issues due to the pandemic and the isolation. We pray for the church members to know how to show their care and those who are hurting. We pray for the church to be impressed with ideas on how to stay connected to the church members. We pray for ways to help students to, as they deal with the disappointments of normal things not happening during the school year and so many restrictions. O God and our Father, forgive us of our sins and where we have come short, and bless us, Lord. And we thank you for the blessings that we receive. Bless each and every one of us. And remember, Lord, we pray for our pastor. Help him, Lord, that he will continue to be strengthened, and his family and the church family in general, we pray in Jesus' name.